Hey everyone, it's Clint with Military Times Gear Scout. This is a mad minute, but it probably won't be a minute. It'll probably be longer. But today we're going to talk about everyday carry belts. Now, this was a pet peeve of mine for a very long time. I was always looking for the perfect belt. I wanted one that was comfortable. I wanted one that didn't have some big buckle on it. I wanted one that was somewhat flexible. I wanted one a certain height or width so that all my clips would actually fit around the entire belt in itself. So there's a lot of little things and relationships between the things you carry and the belt. And so I think I've found some that work, and they come in variety of materials and fasteners. So let's look at those real quick. All right, the first belt. Now, I've had this for years, a black leather belt. And for the longest time, I was like, leather, 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 if you're gonna have EDC stuff. Once leather is broken in, it's probably one of the best materials to have all of your EDC items attached to. So the other thing about them is you can dress them up, dress them down. A black leather belt goes with everything if you're worried about, you know, that whole ensemble thing. But one thing that's unique about mine, you can see I've got it duct taped because I've used it so much. But one thing you can see here is this belt buckle. This is made by Blackside Customs, and it's a pretty cool buckle that's made out of aluminum, lightweight, durable. But the cool thing about it has a magnetic handcuff key in here so that you can get yourself out of a restrained moment. So it's always on your waistline. You would have to move your belt around if your hands were behind you in order to get to that key. But if your hands are in front of you, easy day. Leather, of course, once it's broken in, it has a little bit of give to it, but not much, which is great on your waistline. The only downside to having a big buckle is when you sit down, sometimes this becomes the most uncomfortable aspect of the belt. But leather with a good buckle, you can't go wrong. Now we've got a more advanced everyday carry. This is built by Dynamis Alliance. This is Dom Rosso's company. He's a former SEAL, and he's put together basically a loop and hook or Velcro belt. It does not have a buckle. You put it on and it fastens to itself. So the beauty of this one is it's nylon. So once again, nylon doesn't give, but it has enough give. So if you're carrying a lot of stuff inside the waistband, you have a little bit of that flexibility. You don't have a big belt buckle sticking out in front that when you sit becomes like an obstacle. You don't want that. The other thing is once any of these Velcro belts are connected, you can kind of twist them around on your waistline so that you can put the thin portion wherever you want based on whether it's your blade, a weapon, maybe your med kit, whatever it is you carry on your waistline can fit to the single portion of the belt, you know, not the doubled up portion once you have this on. The other cool features about his belt, he's got hidden little pockets. You could put a handcuff key, maybe extra money, change, whatever you want in here. Down at this end, he's got a couple of other pockets, two of which you could put shims, coins, plenty of little hiding spots for other everyday carry items. But overall, this is a great belt for those that carry a lot of goodies in their waistline. The third belt is this very simple OD green nylon belt. It's kind of thin, but then you know all of the different variation of clips on your knives, your pistol holsters, whatever else you carry will fit around it. It has this harness, like climbing harness-like fastener. I'm not sure that it would actually work in a rescue situation, but it looks cool. It might work. This one is from REI. Like I said, super simple, comfortable, low profile buckle, so it's not jabbing you in the gut. And 511 makes a variant of this too. It's worth checking out, adding to your inventory of EDC belts. All right, my current favorite. Now, I'm very, very simple. So this is about as simple as it gets. This is the loop belt. Now, I got this on Amazon for about $9. It's nylon, it's Velcro, it's thin enough so that all the variants of clips on all my different holsters and blade sheaths work with it. It's super thin. Even once you fasten it, it's still really, really thin. You can rotate it around your waistline so that the thin part and the non-doubled up portion can be used for all of your different clips, your holster sheaths, your med kit, whatever you carry inside the waistband will fit on here just fine. It's lightweight, it's flexible. I tell you, for the price, it is not a bad deal. I think everyone should have a loop belt, you know, part of their inventory. You should check it out. Super simple, easy, and you could have, you know, a stock of them in your drawer used for a variety of things. So check out Loop Belt, Amazon. That's it for today. That's a variation of both leather, nylon, buckle versus Velcro. I think all of them are great. I think all of them are useful. It really just boils down to your personal needs and requirements and what works for you, your waistline, your physique. You know, there's a lot to consider here, but I highly recommend you play with different ones till you find the one you like. I will put all the links for these particular belts and buckles and stuff in the description. Check them out. Make sure you get the full article over at gearscout.militarytimes.com or just hit all the different links that I've got all over the place right now. All right, so that's it for Gear Scout today. Make sure you like us, share us, you know, do all that social media crap, and I will see you later. A broken and fallen, damned old soul's been sent to burn. Now it